Too, even though the entire country has been seeing warmer than normal winter, not nearly as much snow as most people typically see that portion of the country. And here we have some good news. Our latest drought monitor has just come out, and we've seen some improvement. Remember last week's rain? Well, right to the south and east of Austin, we are now have dropped categories. This is really good news. We're most areas still extreme to exceptional, but from Austin south through Caldwell County and into Hays County too, now in the severe category. There is still drought situations out there. It's just not as bad as it was last week before that rain rolled in. And now we're tracking more rain chances for the end of this week. Really good news there, too. Not expecting quite as much as we saw from last week's storm. Let's talk about our current situation outside. Here's a live look in the Hill Country. You can see almost like a haze. Overcast skies, a little bit of fog in some of the low-lying areas, too. The fog settled in late this morning. Really didn't move into the Austin area until after 8 o'clock. Right now, temperatures, everybody's in the 60s. 66 in Llano, same with Burnett, Georgetown, 61 degrees there. Through our eastern counties, a little bit warmer, even in LaGrange, 68 degrees at this hour. Here in Austin, we're sitting at 63. Again, overcast skies, a little bit of fog and haze in the area. Calm wind conditions for the time being. Across the entire state, notice a little wet weather coming in off the coast. These very light showers working through some of our eastern counties, including Fayette County. So we'll continue to see this possibility for a light rain, spotty shower here or there through the rest of your afternoon hours. About a 20% chance for a shower where you live. Now, we're already tracking, though, our bigger rainmaking system we're expecting tomorrow. It's an area of low pressure out over the Four Corners region in the upper levels of the atmosphere. At the surface, it kind of shapes up like this, that area of low pressure with the cold front out past West Texas later on this evening. Tomorrow, it's going to move into West Texas in the morning hours. See a possibility for a few strong storms in North Texas and into Oklahoma overnight tonight, early tomorrow morning. That area is going to shift to the east as this front moves a little bit closer. Still staying just north of our region, mainly Dallas and into Oklahoma affected by this. But that cold front out past the western Hill Country counties by the evening hours, it's going to roll through overnight, bringing us our best chance for some showers, and then finally setting up east of our area by Saturday morning. That means cooler conditions are expected for your weekend. So let's go hour by hour through your forecast. There's that spotty shower activity we're seeing right now. Again, it's going to stay very light through the evening hours tonight, and not everybody will see some of that wet weather. Overnight, the clouds build right back in. Some fog, mist, a little drizzle possible early on your Friday, and then we start to see those rain chances increasing through the evening hours. Your drive home, you should be okay. But as we go through the overnight hours, starting around 8 o'clock and overnight, that line of showers and thunderstorms develops, moves through. So by early Saturday morning, just our eastern counties looking at the leftover of that rain activity. And as far as the strongest storms, looks like they're going to stay just north of our area. Rainfall totals from this wet weather, well, our eastern counties could see maybe 1 to 2 inches. In the Hill Country, generally expecting less than an inch from any sort of shower or storm. Today, here's what you can expect. 72 this afternoon if we get a break in those clouds. If not, it's going to stay in the 60s. The chance for rain continues overnight. Cloudy sky, 62. And for tomorrow, we'll go 75, just a touch warmer ahead of that cold front. Here's that 7-day forecast. Notice the temperature difference between Friday and Saturday. About 15 degrees cooler, staying in the low 60s on your Saturday, and another small chance for a shower on Sunday.